All right, what's up, guys? Good to see everybody. It is Saturday, end of a long week. We are into the weekend. I'm Coach Gav. With me today is Coach Tommy Carter, Coach Marisa, and we're ready to get a kick it off today with a nice long workout. You love the Saturday workouts. We're gonna get a warm up to start first. We're gonna start up high knees to start. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Let's get those knees up. Move those arms by your side. It's a beautiful day. Again, like I said, end of a long week. Getting into the weekend with your families and your friends. All right, 3, 2, 1. Let's get your feet shoulder width apart. Let's get some air squats. It's nice and controlled to come all the way down. We've got a great workout for you today, guys. A lot of repetitions. Some upper body work today, some lower body work. Squatting will be involved. 3, 2, 1. All right, we're just gonna step with our left foot first. Nice big step out. Push off with that front leg. Right, keep that chest up nice and straight. When we're doing our lunges today, we wanna make sure that we're having that nice wide base, especially from our jump squats. A couple more. And one more. Okay, back to high knees again. Let's make sure we get those knees up. Here we go. Be nice and light on your feet. Move your arms by your sides. Good. 5 more seconds. And 3, 2, 1. Good. All right, same thing again. Get those air squats. We're going to hold down the very bottom again. Come down, hold it. And up. Back down again. Track those knees over those toes. Back up. Come on down. Give me 3 more. 2 more. 1 more. And up. Same thing. Let's get a lunge. Step. Push off of that front leg again. Good. Open up these hip flexors in a minute. Okay, now what I want you to do is I want you to come down, hold that left knee down, keep that right leg up, have a vertical shin. Let's put your arms above your head. Really push through in that hip flexor, squeeze that butt. A little lean to the left, and a little lean to the right. Let's take that front leg, straighten it out. Let's grab that toe. Feel that pull on that hamstring. Good. And I'll switch legs. Left leg up, right knee down, hands above your head. Really push that hip flexor through. A little lean. And a little lean again. Good, let's straighten that front leg. Grab that toe one more time. Good, let's stand on up. Let's get the shoulders, let's get some nice, small circles forwards. Make them a little bit bigger. And then all the way out. Good, and let's put those arms up, your palms up this time like you're holding cans of soup. Going backwards, small to start, a little bigger, a little bigger. Get nice big circles. Good, let's take that right arm, put it over top. Try and grab your hand if you see here and just try and grab down through your shoulder blade. Lean over to the left with that right shoulder. Good, and switch it up. Now grab that left, lean to the right. Good, check it on out. Awesome. All right, guys, so what we have here today, we have 6 different movements that you see. So it's going to be 3 rounds per time for each of the 2 movements. So set number 1, 3 rounds, 16 sumo deadlift high pulls. Those are going to be alternating. And then 16 sprinter sit-ups. All right, so when you've done the 16, you go right into 16 sprinter sit-ups and then back up to the deadlifts again. So you do 3 rounds of the first chunk. Then we go right into another three rounds, all right, of a push press, 16, so it's gonna be 8 with your right, 8 with your left. And then 16 jump squats, we do this 3 times. And then we go into our last set, all right, 3 rounds of 16 hand-to-hand swings, kettlebell or dumbbell, all right, that's gonna be alternating, obviously, and then 16 squat thrusts. So what it looks like is there's 96 reps for each of the chunks, works out to be 288 reps total. All right, and this is 4 time. Again, 3 rounds for time, 3 rounds for time, 3 rounds for time. So we're gonna demonstrate here. I'm gonna have Coach Carter here demonstrate the sumo deadlift high pull first with a dumbbell. So when he comes down to that starting position, you can see nice flat back, chest is upright, gaze is forward. Show me a couple reps, Tommy. Brings it up, elbow nice and high, back down again, alternates the arms, back down. Notice how he's keeping that nice long arm and the elbows are coming up nice and high, all right, when he's having that nice pull. Okay, so really make sure long arm, high elbow, okay? After that, he's gonna demonstrate. He's done his 16 reps. He's gonna go in a sprinter sit-up, okay? So notice he's coming up, right arm, left leg, left arm, right leg. So he's reaching all the way up, touching the toes, and coming all the way through. If this is a bit difficult for you, you can just do a regular sit-up, all right, in terms of getting your butterflies out, which is perfectly fine. Again, but that's the sprinter sit-up, okay? Next up is gonna be the push press, okay, and the jump squat. Coach Marisa is gonna demonstrate the push press. She's gonna clean that up. She dips and she drives all the way back up the top, making sure when she's dipping, she's driving up, extending those hips all the way up, all right? So it's gonna be 8 push press with the right and then 8 push press with the left. You can do the transition at the top, it's okay, or you can come down after 8 repetitions, shake it out, and then pick it up and go all the way with the 8 repetitions on the left. Also, when we're dipping, just bring it up again one more time. It's not a squat, it's a dip, okay? So I wanna make sure it's just a nice shallow dip. Knees track up over the toes, extends the hip, drives it all the way up and back down again. Okay, great. All right, Maurice is also gonna demonstrate the squat thrust, or sorry, the jump squats. All right, so what's gonna happen is she comes all the way down, arms up. Notice how her hips are getting below parallel, all right? Toes are pointing when she jumps up, arms are swinging through. It's really important we get that arm momentum swinging all the way through at the top, which is really good. It really helps extend the hips. Back over to Coach Carter. The hand-to-hand swing. What's important here is you can see where the dumbbell starts. It starts out in front of you, okay, in terms of its body position. Back is nice and flat and straight. Gaze right now is looking dead forwards, but as he picks up the kettlebell, he switches hands. Head is following the kettlebell through. Great job. Only going to eye level, so it's a Russian swing hand-to-hand. What's also really important there is when you're doing the hand-to-hand swing, you don't have to have your hand placed in the middle. You can have your hand just slightly to the right, and as you swing it up, you can grab it with your left. That way, it gives yourself a bit more room. Anyone who's got a dumbbell at home, we'll just demonstrate quickly with the dumbbell. Again, same starting position, and he's switching at the very top with his hands. Quick release of the hands, and following the head all the way through. And then once you finish with that, you're gonna do your 16 squat thrusts. He comes all the way down, feet back quickly, and he's landing with flat feet, which is really important. We've talked about this before we're doing our squat thrust. We wanna make sure that we land with flat feet and a jump at the top. All right, guys, so 3 rounds per time. Each particular movement is 96 repetitions in all of those 3 rounds, and we're gonna hit it and get a start. You guys ready? All right, let's do it. All right, 10 seconds on the clock. Here we go, guys. Starting off with those sumo deadlift high pulls. In 3, 2, 1, and begin. Great. We had a little conversation before. This is gonna be a little heated rivalry between the two of these coaches here. See who can finish this first. Again, they're moving really quickly through these sumo deadlift high pulls. Quick transition at the very bottom, keeping that elbow up nice and high. Great job, guys, that's it. Notice you have a nice long arm and then bring that elbow up nice and high when the dumbbell comes up. Quick transition, right to the mat. Great job, guys. Those are reaching, those hands are coming all the way back, reaching for that foot as it comes across. They're going right through this. Great job, guys. That's it. Tommy and Marisa just finished under 1 minute. First round, just shy of 1 minute. Again, moving with the same intensity and consistency. We talk about this a lot. Mechanics, consistency, intensity. All right, move well all the time, and then dial up the weight and the speed. Good job, guys. It's important too, guys, when we are talking about the intensity and the speed, we don't lose our form. Good job, guys. That's it. Coming up to finish round two here. Let's see if you guys at home can keep up with the coaches. But again, maintaining your form, maintaining your mechanics. Great job, guys. Again, second round completed in just south of 1 minute. Looks like they're gonna finish these three rounds in just around the 3 minute mark. Great job, guys, that's it. Awesome work. Two minutes, 30 seconds. And then again, they're moving right to their sit-ups, all right? They're actually going faster this round than they did the first two rounds. So when you're finished this, you're gonna go right to your dumbbell and you can start with your push press. It's gonna be 8 push press with the right, 8 push press with the left. Great job, guys, that's it. All right, again, finish sub 3. And here we go, right to the first part of the second or the third movement. These push press, dip and drive. Arms are extending all the way up. Hip extension. Marisa switches at the top. Tommy switches at the top. Notice you can watch both of their feet while they're doing this. You can see that they come up slightly up on their toes, which helps with the hip extension. All right, jump squats. Again, making sure they're both getting below parallel. All right, their hips are getting below their knees. Extending all the way up. Great job, guys, that's it. Awesome work. And again, that was a 45 second round. Again, so a little bit quicker the second part of the workout. All right, we wanna try and maintain this pace as we go through all the rounds. Great job, guys, that's it. Tommy switches at the top, Marisa switches at the top, driving all the way through. Great job, guys, that's it. If you're at home, like I said, keep up with these coaches, all right? There's a faster style workout here based on the movements that we're doing. You can hear them both breathing right now too. Crushing round number two here. Great job, guys. 4 minutes, 35 seconds in. You can see they went even faster. All right, they're maintaining that 45 second round time here. That's it, guys. Great job. Come on. Push the pace. Push the pace. Great job, Marisa. That's it. Extend all the way up. That's it, Tommy. Come on now. Come on now. That's it, guys. Nice work. You see they're maintaining that pace as soon as you go through. All right, Marisa onto the hand-to-hand swings. All right, following the dumbbell head through up to eye level. There we go, there we go. Great job, guys. Awesome work. That's it. Marisa on those squat thrusts now. Burner style workout today, everybody. Burner style workout. Good job, guys. That's it. Both onto the squat thrusts. Feet are coming back. Like I said before, when we come back up, we come to flat feet. We don't want to come up on our toes on these squat thrusts, all right? Make sure your feet come all the way through, the hips come all the way through, jump at the very top. Great job, guys, that's it. Come on. All right, Marisa under a second round. Good job, guys, that's it. Full extension of the hips. Nice job, guys, that's it. Notice when they're coming through the kettlebell and the dumbbell. It's extension with their arm all the way to eye level, and they're following the kettlebell or the dumbbell as it goes through their legs, right? It's a hip pop. We're not squatting when we do these hand-to-hand swings. Good job, you're 7 minutes in, guys. Great job. That's it. Here we go. Come on. If you're at home, this is where you want to pick it up a little bit. I know you've been going hard. We're almost to the end here. 7:30. Great job, guys. These two coaches are really pushing the pace. Tommy reaching up to here. Going his last round of hand-to-hand swings. Come on, guys, come on. Still maintaining that form. All right, guys, here we go, come on. If you're at home, really push that pace to the very end here. Come on, guys, come on. All right, here we go. We're at 8 minutes, 10 seconds. Come on, let's go, come on. Push to the end, push to the end. That's it, guys, come on. These guys are going right to the very end here. Come on, guys, come on. We're almost there, almost there. Nice job, guys, come on. Last couple reps. Hup. Yeah, well done, well done. Great job, guys, awesome work. You can see they finished at just around the 8-minute, 40-second mark. All right, if you're at home, keep going right now. All right, depending on where you are in your rounds. All right, keep the mechanics, keep moving, but if you're getting to the very end of this workout, push the pace. All right, guys, push the pace at the very end. Great job. You can see that's how we get fitter. When you push yourself at the very end of the workout, when you feel like you got nothing left, you just gotta go. Both these coaches on their hands and knees right now, you can tell. They're both fit, very fit individuals. This is a great workout. On their hands and knees, you know you did a great job. Keep pushing at home, guys. Give these guys another minute or so before we do a cool down stretch. But if you're at home, I want you to keep going, right? Don't stop. If you're working out with a partner at home, push your partner, right? If you finish before your partner, make sure you support them while they finish their workout. Right? It's one thing that we really, really strive for here is our sense of community, our sense of togetherness, and our sense of family. Good job, guys. All right, a few more seconds here. I'm gonna cool these guys down. Like I said, if you're still working out at home, absolutely no problem. Go to the very end. If you are finished, take a quick breather. All right, grab yourself some water. It's always really important too, if you have a yoga mat, bring out the yoga mat at home. Turn on some different music to try and calm that body down after a workout just like this. That was more of a sprint style workout, getting through all of it, 288 repetitions. These guys did it in sub 9 minutes. All right, so if we're finished at home, and if you're finished up, we're just gonna come down on our knees. Just gonna come down with this cat-cow position. I want you nice, arch that back nice and slowly. And then bring that chin up and through. Be deliberate in this movement. Kind of hold each position for a few seconds. Good. What I want you to do is I want you to take your left arm, I want you to put it out, and I want you to take your right arm and put it through and roll over onto that shoulder. Just kind of relax in this position. Good. Switch arms. Right arm out, left arm through. Good, just push your head through in a child's pose. Good, let's come up onto our feet. Our butts. Feet out in front. Let's grab those toes. Try and bring that chin down. Good, slowly come up to your feet. Get your feet together. We'll do a Jefferson curl. So we're gonna roll out the neck, roll out the upper back, hands in front, slowly come down. Slowly come on up, every spine, nice and easy. And let's do that one more time. Tuck that chin in. Roll those shoulders over, slide those hands down the legs. And come back up. All right, guys, great job at home. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Have yourself a wonderful weekend, and we'll see you on Monday.